Skylights are associated with their parent roof or shell, so they adjust and reorient themselves automatically when the geometry of that roof or shell changes. For example, if we change the slope of a roof, the skylight will readjust itself to the new slope. Or, if we modify the profile polygon of a shell, the skylight again adjusts itself to the new geometry. When a skylight is placed into a roof, a setting in the Skylight Settings dialog defines how the skylight should adjust itself after a change in the roof geometry. The constraint in Roof Field has two options, horizontal and vertical. Let us set this option to horizontal for the skylight on the left, and to vertical for the skylight on the right, so we can see the difference in the results. If we change the slope of the roof, the skylight on the left has been set to the horizontal option. Therefore, when viewed from the top, it will remain in the same position and change its vertical position in the roof based on the new roof slope. The skylight on the right has been set to the vertical option, which means that its vertical position relative to the pivot line of the roof will remain the same. Therefore, it will adjust itself horizontally according to the new roof slope. There is also a setting in the Roof Settings dialog that affects skylights. It is the Fit Skylights to Curve checkbox of the Multiplane Geometry panel. We have it checked now. The pivot line of the roof has a curved portion, and this portion is divided into four segments. With our checkbox checked, skylights will orient themselves radially. Their axis will lie on the radius of the curved pivot line. This way, they may not align with the slope of the roof they are placed into. If we uncheck the Fit Skylights to Curve checkbox, then skylights will align with the slope of the roof planes they are placed into. With this setting, skylights placed into the roof all lie parallel to each other in the roof plane.